press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello my dear students, welcome back to the classroom. We have been discussing about the chapter Air Around Us. See, in the previous class we learnt about the composition of the air and also how the oxygen is present in the air as well as the in the water, how the oxygen, presence of oxygen in the water as well as the soil we will learn. See, in the previous class we also learnt how the presence of oxygen in the water and in the water dissolved form of oxygen is present, and thereby these dissolved form of oxygen will be utilized by all living organisms which are floating in the water, not only the fishes, octopus, dolphins, but also the plants which are living in the water will also utilize the amount of dissolved oxygen in the water. So here in the previous class we also learnt that soil is also contain the oxygen, and say for doing this activity we will learn how the amount of oxygen is present in the soil. So the name of the activity is the activity name is to show the presence of air in the soil. To show the presence of oxygen or the air in soil. See, this is the name of the activity. To show the presence of oxygen in the soil. See, the material required for this activity is we have to take the glass jar or a container we have to take, and a lump of dry soil we have to take, and next the water we have to take for this activity. See, usually the space between the soil particles which contains the air. Soil particles contains the space. The soil particles which contain the space, in this space air is present. And the bubbles of the air appears. See, the bubbles of the air will appear when the water is pushes the air out of the space. Thereby we can say that the air will escape from the water and in the form of a bubble. See, this is how the bubble will be formed, and these bubbles are nothing but the air bubble. That is, it shows that the presence of oxygen in the soil. And for doing this activity, first we have to take a lump of soil in a beaker or any container, and slowly we have to add the water, and after adding the water to the lump of dry soil, you can see the bubbles will be formed, and these bubbles are nothing but the air bubble. That is, the soil contains the amount of oxygen, and usually the soil is having the space, and this space is filled with the air. When we add the water into the lump of the soil, this water will push us out the air, and which is present in between the space of the lump of the soil. This oxygen will be, water will pushes the air out of the space, and from this the air will be escape from the water or the lump of soil. And it is a easy activity you can do in your home also. By taking the any kinds of vessel you have to take, and a lump of soil. See, a lump of dry soil we have to take, And next we have to add slowly water to it, and thereby we can say that the air, when we add into the dry lump of soil, the air will push us the water will push us the air out of these spaces. Usually the soil particles having the space, and these space is filled with the air, and when we add the water into the soil, dry lump of soil, then the water pushes the air out of this space, and which creates the bubble, and these bubbles is nothing but the air bubble, that is oxygen is in the form of oxygen, it will in the form of bubble, this oxygen air is nothing but the oxygen in the form of bubble, it will escape from the lump of the soil. And this is all about the activity. From this activity we can conclude that air is present in the soil. See, conclusion is air is present in soil. When we add the water into the lump of soil, the water will pushes the air out of these spaces, that is lump of soil, and here the bubble is formed, and this bubble is nothing but the oxygen bubble which is present in the nature. And see, from this activity we can conclude that air is present in the soil. So next we shall move on to the replacement of the oxygen in the atmosphere. How the oxygen and different gases will exchange in the atmosphere we will learn now. A replacement of oxygen in atmosphere. See, usually air contains different gases like carbon dioxide, nitrogen, oxygen, and different etc. different types of gases will be present. And let me see in this heading how the oxygen is present in the atmosphere, how the oxygen will be replaced. Usually all living organisms will utilize the amount of oxygen present in the nature. Organism utilize the oxygen present in the nature, and in turn all the organisms will release the carbon dioxide. See, in turn all the living organisms will exhale the carbon dioxide. Not only the organisms will exhale the carbon dioxide, even though the vehicles also emit the carbon dioxide which is coming out from the vehicle. And the process of respiration use the oxygen present in the air, but this is constantly replaced by the plants. For respiration process, oxygen is very essential. It is an energy giving process, usually takes place in the body of an organism, which is responsible for the growth as well as the development. And here in the respiration process, oxygen is very essential, and in turn the oxygen is utilized by the living organisms, exhale the carbon dioxide to the nature, and this carbon dioxide will be utilized by all green plants. And in this way, the carbon dioxide as well as the oxygen will be replaced in the nature. And also for the process of photosynthesis, the plants will take in the carbon dioxide and as a simple substance, and thereby the plants will release the oxygen to the atmosphere, and that process is known as the photosynthesis. It is nothing but the food preparing process, where the plants will utilize the simple substance like carbon dioxide as well as the water at the presence of sunlight and the chlorophyll pigment in the leaf. And usually the chlorophyll is a green pigment, and make the food, that is starch or the glucose, it will make and release the oxygen to the atmosphere. And these amount of oxygen will be utilized by all living organisms. Plants also consume the oxygen for the respiration, but compared to the process of photosynthesis, the plants will absorb more amount of carbon dioxide as compared to the oxygen. And here in plants also, the respiration will be takes place, and in the respiration process it will take the oxygen, and this oxygen is compared to the carbon dioxide very less amount it will absorb, and so that the plants will considered as produce oxygen. Usually the plant produce or released oxygen. See, the all living organisms utilize the amount of oxygen for the respiration process. Here plants also utilize the amount of oxygen for the respiration purpose. Compared to the carbon dioxide, oxygen is very less it will utilized, and so the plant will also called as it is considered to be as produce the oxygen. Oxygen will be produced by the plant, and animals can't live without the plants. See, the interdependence of the animals as well as the plant will be takes place, and the animals, all the living organisms beside this plant, other living organisms can't be live in this earth without the plants, and thereby the interdependence of the animals as well as the plant will be takes place, and maintains the balance in the nature. And also maintain balance in nature. Living organisms depends on plants, and in turn the plants will depends on living organisms. Like if we not provided the water regularly, then the plants will become fall down to the earth, and thereby we can say that and if the plants will not provided with a proper nutrition or proper fertilizers, then the plant will become the decay, or disease may get the plant. So that the interdependence of the living organisms over the plant will be takes place, and this may create the balance in the nature. And it maintained through the respiration in the plants and animals by the process of photosynthesis. This will shows the interdependence of the plants and animals. Interdependence of plant and animals. So this is all about the replacement of oxygen in the nature. So in the replacement of oxygen, oxygen is very essential for all living organisms. Usually the plant releases the oxygen to the atmosphere, and thereby all living organisms utilize the amount of oxygen for respiration purpose, and it is one of the energy giving process. And plants also respire the oxygen. Compared to the carbon dioxide, very less amount of oxygen they will utilize, and so that the plants plant will produce the oxygen. It is considered to be a plant producer, and all living organisms will depend on the plant, and where the plants will depend on the living organisms for many other ways, and so that it will create a balance in the nature, and it is also called the interdependence of the plants as well as the animals. And this is all about the heading replacement of oxygen. Not only the oxygen, carbon dioxide and exchange will be takes place, so that it is a interdependence of the plants as well as the animals. Next we shall move on to the uses of the air. There are some uses of the air will be present. From this uses we will learn how the air is important for all living organisms. Without the air, no living beings will be present in the or survive in this earth. Uses of plant. The first use of this plant is air exerts pressure on object, and that comes in this way. Air exerts pressure when the objects come in this way, it exerts a pressure, and air regulates the temperature. Air regulates the temperature. See, if high temperature and low temperature will be takes place with the help of the air only, it regulates the temperature in the nature. And also air is used by living organisms for the breathing. Air used by living organisms air is utilized by all living organisms for breathing purpose. See, usually the air contains the many types of gases, and the major components of air is the nitrogen, and this nitrogen is utilized for manufacture of the fertilizers. Nitrogen used for manufacture of fertilizers. And the air is also helpful for the dispersal of the seed. See, only in the nature we learnt about, in this class we will learnt about the water cycle. Beside this water cycle, when you go higher classes, you will learn the oxygen cycle as well as the nitrogen cycle, and this air will maintain these cycles like water cycle, water, nitrogen and oxygen cycle. It maintains So this is all about the uses of the air. See, in which first use is air exerts the pressure. When the object or the things will comes in this way, it will exert the pressure, and air regulates the temperature. It will maintains and regulates the temperature, and air is used by all living organisms for breathing. Even though the aquatic organisms also utilize the amount of oxygen in the dissolved way. Nitrogen is used for them. Usually the air contains the different components, and the major components of the air is the nitrogen, and this nitrogen is used for manufacture of the fertilizers, and usually the fertilizers will sprinkle to the plants for growth as well as for development. And sometimes if plants will get any diseases, then these fertilizers helpful the plants for getting rid of these diseases or disorders in the plants. See, it also helpful for dispersal of the seed by the wind only. It is acts as an agent. It will helpful for dispersal of the seed. It will moves away the seeds from other places. And in this class we will learn about the water cycle. In when we go to higher classes, you will learn about the nitrogen cycle as well as the water cycle. These air will maintain water, nitrogen, as well as the oxygen cycle. It will maintains. And some other uses of the air is also used for inflate the tires of the vehicle. Inflate the tires of the vehicle. Used for inflate the inflate the tires of vehicles. See, these are all about the uses of the air. Some other uses of the air is also present. See, air is also used for winnowing process. As we learnt in the separation of the substance, air is also used for winnowing process, and air helps in movement of the sailing yacht, gliders, parachutes, etc. Air helps for movement of yachts, gliders, and the sailboat, etc. And usually the air is responsible for rotating the windmill, and thereby the blades of the windmill will rotate, and which generates the electricity. And this is only with the help of air only, and it also helps in the it plays an important role in the water, nitrogen, as well as the oxygen cycle. See, this is all about the uses of the air. See, air is responsible for the winnowing process, as we learnt in the separation of the substance, and air is helpful for the movement of the yacht, gliders, and even the sailboat also. It is responsible, and usually the air is used for inflate the tires of the vehicles. See, these are all about the uses of the air. Next, we shall move on to the important points, which is helpful for this chapter. I will write on the board now. See, we all know that breeze is nothing but the slow moving of the air is called as breeze. Whereas very speed voltage of the speed movement of the air is called as storm. And next one is the storm is the where the air will be move at a very high speed and it damages the many living organisms. Next one is the nitrogen. See, it is one of the components of the air. Usually the air contains the major components. Around 78.8% it is present. Major component of air. And the oxygen is, compared to the nitrogen, oxygen is very less quantity component of the air. Around 21% of oxygen is present in the air. And next one is the atmosphere. See, atmosphere is nothing but a blanket, protective blanket, a thin layer of the air. A thin layer of air which protect against the UV radiation from the sun. A thin layer. A thin layer, blanket of the air or blanket of air. Which surrounds the thin layer or the blanket of the air which surrounds the earth. And also the water vapor is nothing but the moisture content. The water present in the gaseous form is called as water vapor, and usually the water vapor is also contained in the air. It is one of the component of the air. And next, smoke is nothing but very small particles which is present in the air. And this is all about the key learning points. So in today's class we will learn these points. We will meet in the next class. Stay safe and keep learning. Thank you.